Seems the only thing the Calamity saved for Zulf was a smoking pipe. The Marshal seemed like a good man, he says. They treated him with dignity. Zulf brought his antique smoking pipe all the way from the terminals. Hearty punch is so zesty, it'll let you carry on through the worst of times. The Breakers, ain't no one could outrun them, or their arrows. The Gravers, the Arm of Justice, they seemed unstoppable. Poor kid collapses after just one drag. The past. Only good thing ever come out of the past is history. Catches up with the kid. Hardly had a moment's rest since all this started. Fair to say he's led a hard life. Supposing what he says in his sleep ain't no lie. He never knew his old man, but he had his mama to take care of. Frail thing with pure white hair like his. Having his mama's hair did the kid no favors while he was growing up, but he learned to hold his own out there. School ain't working out, so the kid signs up for a turn on the rippling walls. Make his mama some money. Thanks to folks like the kid, the walls kept Ceylandia safe from whatever's out there. The elements, the Ura, you name it. Once the kid done his time, he hurried on home. Turns out his mama's time was done too. Huh? city had nothing for him. The money he'd been sending home was nowhere to be found either. So what'd the kid do? Why, he went right on back to the walls for another 5 years. In the history of Ceylandia, nobody's ever volunteered for a second shift on the walls. How dare kid learn to fend for himself? Learn to build, learn to break. Time the kid earned good standing with the marshals. They trusted him to scout out farther than anybody. One night, on one of his expeditions, the ground beneath him shuddered, cracked, and split apart. He saw nothing. Where the world used to be. The calamity happened just like that. All the kid had to work with was his hammer and the clothes on his back. Through twisted streets, he ran with nothing but the city crest and an old stranger's voice to guide him. We'll be right back. finally arrived at Ceylandia's vaulted safe haven. He and no one else. But then, all he got was more thankless work from a man who ain't even asked his name. Sure, I may be the one who dreamt up the walls and the bastion, but the kid made him real, not me. I'd like to say I'll never forget him, or what he's doing, what he's done. I surely would.